Taxation is theft, but it's not a popular opinion. A lot of people state that, well, you get something in return, so it's a transaction. It's not a robbery. No, it's definitely a robbery, because with government, you're always paying for something that you don't want. Everybody's got something that they don't want to pay for that they're currently paying for. And that is an involuntary transaction. They're taking that money also using violence. It's a damn robbery. It's theft. What about this transaction the government forces you into? Do you like weed prohibition? Weed being illegal? Something that's harmless? The drug war kills more people than drugs itself. Do you like your money going towards the drug war? Again, let me repeat that. The drug war kills more people than drugs itself. And you really want a drug war. Yeah, if you're smart, you don't. And that's an involuntary transaction. That is theft. What about all that money that you're spending on war? Do you like war? Is war something that you want to spend your hard-earned money on? Because if not, then that's an involuntary transaction, and that's theft. How about your money going towards droning brown children overseas? Do you condone that? Do you like your money going towards that? If not, then that's an involuntary transaction, and that is theft. As you know, it's not uncommon for cops to kill dogs for no reason. Kill people for no reason. Hurt people for no reason. Hell, they'll even do it getting caught on camera, and they'll still get away from it. The worst that'll happen to them is a paid vacation. Do you like your money going towards letting these guys off the hook? Do you like the fact that your money's going towards putting these psychopaths on the force to protect you and your kids? Think about that. Yes, your hard-earned money is going to ensure that psychopaths are on the force. No matter how heinous of a crime a police officer commits, they stay on the force, and you're going to pay for it. I doubt you want that. And if you don't want that, that's an involuntary transaction, and that is theft. All I'm saying is if police were privatized, you would get to choose what police officer protects you and your family. You would get to choose what private security company protects you and your family. See, with the government, they're going to take your money no matter what, and they're going to spend it on whatever the hell they want. You don't get to choose where your money goes, like in the free market. It's not a voluntary transaction. So if it's not voluntary, and they're using force to take your money, like extortion, putting you in a cage like an animal, or kidnapping you, then it's theft. Let's say you have a small government, right? And there's only 10 things your money goes towards. And 8 of those are voluntary, but 2 of them aren't. Well, you gotta pay for all of them, so it's an involuntary system. It's theft. It doesn't all have to be theft for the system to be theft. But let's be honest here. Everything with government is 100% theft because you have to pay for it no matter what. Yeah, a few transactions you may approve of and you feel like you're getting something back, but it doesn't mean it's the same for your neighbor. Your neighbor may feel that's theft. Imagine you don't want to pay for drug prohibition or you don't want to pay for war, but your neighbor does. And he's forcing you to pay for that shit because he's using the violence of the state to force you to pay for it via voting. That's not a voluntary transaction. That's theft. Here's another way to look at it. Imagine you go to McDonald's to order something, right? And you order a Big Mac. Okay, you want a Big Mac with extra tomatoes, no cheese, and no mustard. Okay, but instead of giving you a Big Mac, they give you a quarter pounder with cheese. And yeah, they give you extra tomatoes, but they also give you mustard and cheese, the two things you didn't want. Now they're forcing a gun on you and telling you you have to do the transaction. Now, is that a voluntary transaction or is that theft? Answer that. It sounds like theft to me. Call me crazy. Some will say, well, you choose to live here, so you have to deal with our rules. Let me explain to you the birth of the government in the United States of America. Okay, imagine a house, right? And it's a pretty big house. There's 5 people that live in it. 3 of the 5 people have decided that we're going to order pizza every single night. And we're going to split the bill. And on every Tuesday, they're going to get Chinese. Oh, and anybody that doesn't pay gets put in the closet for a day. There's 2 people that disagreed, right? Just like in the United States of America, when the government was born, there was they may not be the majority, But there was a lot of people that lived here that already had houses built here that they were forced under this massive overreaching government that they didn't want to live under. Just imagine that you lived on the corner of the street and I decided to move right next door to you with some of my friends. And we all decided to make our own government and we just forced you under that government. How? Well, because we're the majority and the majority rules, right? And you have a kid and your kid is born in this government and now they got to obey by our rules. You have no say because you're the minority. Me, the popular ones, you know, the majority, have all the say. You have zero. Well, I think that's bullshit. I think everybody should have a say. And under the free market, everybody does have a say because you vote with your dollar. And every vote counts to the corporations. Not every vote counts to the government, but every vote, every dollar counts to the corporations for sure. You don't need the majority to put a business under. If Walmart tomorrow lost 3% of its income, it would go under. Walmart can't afford to piss off the minority because if they do, their business goes under. So not only does the majority have complete control over the corporations, so does the minority. Everybody has power under capitalism. Everybody. Under government, the minority have no control. The majority don't even have any control. For example, let's say the problem is the United States Post Office. What are they going to replace it with? The United States Post Office. Probably with the same workers. Government doesn't give you choice. It gives you the illusion of choice. The government is involuntary. It gives you the illusion of voluntary because it gives you some of the stuff you want. But most of what it gives you is exactly the opposite of what you want. If the government's stealing your money, and what you want when your money's being stolen from you is at least a fancy car, but instead the government gives you AIDS, yeah, I don't think you're going to be happy. I don't think you're going to say that's a voluntary transaction. I think you're going to say that was theft and rape.